The story is told of a very wicked king. It seems he asked the best blacksmith in his whole kingdom. To make a very strong chain. So the blacksmith asked the king to give him money. So the king gave him as much money as he wanted. So the blacksmith went and made a very strong chain. And he brought it back to the king. The king looked at the chain. It was very strong. But he said, I want you to make it bigger. The man said, King, why do you want it bigger? He said, because I want to tie a man with this chain. Sir, I'll need more money to make a bigger chain. So the king gave him more money. He went and made a bigger chain. He brought it back to the king. It was strong and big. But the king said, I want it even bigger. The man said, I want more money. The king gave him more money. So he went back and made a bigger chain. When the chain was really big, when the chain was really strong, then the king asked his soldiers to catch the man. The very man who made the chain. And they tied him from his door right to his head with the same chain. And they hanged him up on the roof. And everybody began to see in horror. And the man began to scream. Every time I hear that story, I think of what Satan is doing to people. He gives them pleasures of life. He makes the chain longer and longer. And his only desire is to tie you up. His only desire is to break you down. His only desire is to destroy you. But tonight Jesus desires to set you free. This is the last evening of our meeting. God has been speaking to us from His Word. Tonight we pray that God would speak again. If man speaks, nothing will happen. But when the eternal God begins to speak, hearts will be set in liberty. And so this evening I want to invite you to pray with me. We want to close our eyes and bow our heads. We want to ask God to speak to us tonight. You ask God to speak to you this evening. Let's pray together. Lord, we ask that you would speak to us this evening. Lord, it is your desire that no man, no woman perish. Lord, Satan wants to bind us down. But Jesus wants to give us liberty tonight. We ask that you would speak, Master. Draw us closer to yourself. We ask that the glory of this evening will belong to Jesus. May He be lifted up tonight. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
Every time we open the New Testament, in the very first verse, the Bible talks about Jesus, and the Bible also talks about David. 바이블 다운티가 온 바가나.
I want to read for you the first verse of Matthew chapter 1.
마태 오다에서니 포차가 보라이치 나가나.
The Bible says this is the record of the genealogy of Jesus Christ.
바로 얀 우아머니 마음비고 시안이 마참.
The son of David.
아노완 지쇼라 다운티디 번제니 미소가.
Every time you open the Bible.
나 바이블 그 우아 장한진.
In the very first verse.
스카무르 포토.
You have the name of Jesus.
지쇼니 비몽 동겐.
And you have the name of David.
다운티디 비몽 바 동겐.
And Jesus is called the son of David.
아노 지쇼코 다운티디 번제니 하가나.
And then if you come down to verse 6.
아르바 포도 꺼내리 바오데.
In Matthew chapter 1 and verse 6.
마티오다에서 포도.
The Bible says David was the father of Solomon.
나오더라 솔로몬의 바가봉아.
Whose mother had been another man's wife.
오늘 제니 잠깐만 높은 만드니 즉 사참냐가나.
David lived 1,000 years before Jesus came into this world.
나오 지순이 레바이나 벌써 하자 스캉장기장아.
Matthew is writing the gospel 1,000 years after David had died.
다운티 시안이 벌써 하자는 산이 자원에서 마티야 남아갔다고서야.
Oh, David did many great things in his life.
Oh, 다운타라 오늘 장기 장원에 달라카라고가.
David wrote many of the psalms in the Bible.
다운야 기드라만의 그바 방알 기드라곤서야.
David gave Israel many victories.
이스라엘은 와 방알 시안이 그라 방알.
David was a man after God's heart.
다운타라 이솔이 가 돈그다 그바만데.
David did many great things for God.
다운 방알 달라카라
And yet I'd like us to recognize something tonight. 1,000 years after David died. When Matthew writes about David. He remembers only one thing. He remembers that David begat Solomon. Through another man's wife.
사건이 저거보니 고사.
Oh how sad.
나면 죽니.
That after 1,000 years.
벌써 하자는 산에 잡아라.
One thing they remember about David.
나온지가만 기스가라 코네라.
Is the sin of David.
완나온지 파포마.
Tonight we want to look at just two thoughts from God's word.
야이 소니 갔다 오니까 뭔가니 고사 나를 연다스가.
Number one, I want us to consider the fact that sin is painful.
스카운더바오니 기스가라다 나는 아니라 파포라 사득 정못 그만.
But the second thought that I want us to consider is
Yes,
sin is painful. But my Savior is powerful. 1,000 years ago, David died. 1,000 years later, they still remember his sins. Sin is painful, my friend.
Oh, 파파라 남 맨 사크나니와.
Tonight, as we look at the life of David,
나오는 장기장을 그 원한이었던.
I want to remind you of a few lessons on sin.
아, 파니가만 야나코스키라 지나마스카.
Sin is painful.
파데 사크나.
I want us to consider five thoughts about sin tonight.
파니가만 아분 봉아 천천이라고 나스카.
Number one, the pleasures of sin are short-lived.
파니 숙라마라 득득 사산.
The Bible says in Hebrews. Chapter 11 and verse 25. Moses did not want to be considered the son of Pharaoh. But he chose to be identified with his people. Because he knew that sin, the pleasures of sin were short-lived. The first lesson I learned from David is that the pleasures are short-lived. In 2 Samuel chapter 11,
Samuel is coming up.
The Bible says this was the time when kings went to war. But David did not go to war. He was knocking on his rooftop. And then he saw a beautiful woman. And David said, I want that woman. When you read 2 Samuel chapter 11,
in
the first four verses, David lusted after the woman.
David
got the woman. David slept with the woman. And then verse 5 happens. And in verse 5 the Bible says, but Sheba sends words to David. She says, I am pregnant now. All the pleasures of sin are short-lived. David wanted to enjoy himself. But David realizes that the pleasures of sin are short-lived. The Bible says in Romans chapter 6 and verse 23,
that
the wages of sin is death. There was a lady who was walking on the street one night. And as she was walking on the street, she found a beautiful necklace on the road. Like all other women, she picked up the necklace. And she began to run. But as she was running, she said, robbers might see me. If they see me, they'll snatch the chain from me. So she said, I must hide my chain. So she opened her mouth and put the chain in her mouth. And she began to run. She ran a few steps. She fell down and she died. Everybody was surprised. They took her to the hospital. They did a postmortem. And the postmortem surprised everybody. Because what looked like a beautiful chain in the night was a deadly snake. All the wages of sin is death. David looked at Bathsheba. Oh, she looked beautiful. He said, I want her. In four verses, he got her. But in the fifth verse, the pleasures of sin are short-lived. Now David is saying, why did I do it? I didn't want this woman to get pregnant. Why did this happen to me? It happened to you because the Bible says that the pleasures of sin are short-lived. There's a second lesson about sin that I learned tonight. Be sure your sin will find you out. The Bible says in Numbers chapter 32 and verse 23, be sure your sin will find you out. You're sitting here tonight. You're saying nobody knows my sin. I want to tell you, be sure your sin will find you out. David was the king. He sinned. He committed adultery. And then to cover his sin, he killed a man. He thought to himself, nobody knows what I've done. But as you read 2 Samuel chapter 12, the prophet Nathan walks into David's court. And he says, David, God wants to confront you. He said, there was a rich man. That rich man had many goats and sheep and lambs. One day a guest came to the rich man's house. But the rich man looks at his neighbor's house. And his neighbor had just one ewe lamb. And he took that lamb. And he killed that lamb. Now David was angry. And he said, that man needs to be put to death. Nathan said, David, you are the man. You might be a king, but you can't hide your sins from God. Be sure your sin will find you out. Today we have the LCD projector. We have the computer. All our worship songs come on the screen. There was a pastor in the United States. He had just 6 months to retire.
He
put on his computer. He turned on the LCD. And he wanted worship songs to come on the screen. But accidentally the pastor pressed the wrong button. And instead of worship songs, there was pornography on the screen. Because the pastor was a pornography addict. The pleasures of sin are short-lived. Be sure your sin will find you out. Number three, what you sow, you will reap. The Bible says in the book of Galatians chapter 6 verses 7 and 8, God cannot be mocked. What a man sows, that a man will reap. And I want to tell you tonight, what you sow, you will reap. David sowed to lust. David sowed to murder.
David
was an adulterous man. David was a murderer. When you go back and read the story of David, the Bible says David's own son
Absalom,
he slept with David's wives. David sold to adultery. Adultery came back into his family. If you read 2 Samuel chapter 13, Haman defiles Tamar. You know why? Because you reap what you sow. David said, I am going to enjoy adultery. God said, David, what you sow, you will reap. David murdered. And if you read the story of David's life, in his own family, there were murders after murders. Because you reap what you sow. There was a man in my previous church. He came to me crying one day. He said, Pastor, I am not able to do anything with my sons. I can't control them at all. They are terribly disobedient. And then he fell to his knees. And he raised his hands up to heaven. And he cried like a little baby. And he said, my sons are like this because of me. Pastor, before I accepted Jesus, I used to drink terribly. I used to come back home and beat my wife. My son saw that, Pastor. Today I am reaping what I sow. The Bible says a man will reap what he sows. You can't get away, my friend. Number one. The pleasures of sin are short-lived. Number two, be sure your sin will find you out. Number three, what you sow, you will
reap.
Number four, our sin separates us from God. The book of Isaiah chapter 59 and verse 2. The Bible says, because of your sins, God has turned his face from you. David sinned. And as a result of that sin, God and David were separated. David had no more relationship of closeness with God. At one time, this man sang about God. At one time this man was close to God. But today, because of sin, he is far away from the things of God. I don't know if there's somebody like that here tonight. At one time you were so close to God. But today, because of sin, you have gone far away. You're saying, at one time I was even a deacon in my church. But today everything has gone cold in my life. Oh, sin separates me from God. David had to realize that very painful lesson. Sin separated him from God. The pleasures of sin are short-lived. Be sure your sin will find you out. What you sow, you will reap. Sin separates you from God. And number five, the shame of sin doesn't leave you easily. David sinned 1,000 years ago. 1,000 years later, they still remember David's sin. Listen carefully to me. Jesus forgives sin. But I have to bear the consequences of my sin. No matter who you are, even the pastor, even the deacon, no matter who you are, Jesus will forgive your sins. But you will bear the consequences of your sin. There was a little boy who would always speak lies. So his father wanted to teach him a lesson. The father said, every time you speak a lie, I'm going to put a nail on the front door of our house. So when the boy spoke a lie, a father put the nail in the front door. When there were one or two nails, the boy didn't bother. But soon the door became full of nails. And every time people came to the house, they would look at the door. And they would say, what are all these nails? And the father would say, my son is a liar. So the boy felt very angry one day. He felt broken-hearted one day. So he said, Daddy, I will speak the truth now. So the father said, whenever you speak the truth, I'll remove a nail. So he began to speak the truth. And the father began to remove the nails. One day all the nails came away. Oh, the boy was happy. But he was sad. He looked at the door. And the door had a lot of holes. He said, Daddy, what about the holes? Jesus can forgive my sins. But I have to bear the consequences of it. David sinned 1,000 years ago. One mistake. He did many great things. But one mistake. They still remember it. The pleasures of sin are short-lived. Be sure your sin will find you out. What you sow, you will reap. Sin separates me from God. The shame of sin is remembered for a long time. Tonight, my friend, are you sitting here somewhere? You know you're living in sin. You know there are things in your life that are not right. God says to you tonight, the fruits of sin are painful. I want to remind you tonight, the fruits of sin are painful. But there's a second thought that I want to leave with you tonight. Yes, sin is painful. But how beautiful. My Savior is powerful. When I read Matthew chapter 1, so many times tears fill my eyes. Because this sinful man David, when God talks about Jesus, when God talks about his only begotten son, he says, my son is the son of David. Oh, how beautiful. I wouldn't call my daughter the daughter of David. David was a murderer. David was an adulterer. I wouldn't want my daughter to be called the daughter of David. But the eternal God, he says, my son Jesus is the son of David. You know why? Because my Savior is powerful. In all of the New Testament, the one title that is used for Jesus the most is the Son of David. Matthew chapter 1 talks about the son of David. And if you turn to the last chapter of the book of Revelation, Revelation chapter 22, verse 16, God talks about his son again. And he says he is the son of David. You know why? Because my Savior is powerful. What did he do for me? He did three things for me, my friend. Number one, he sent Jesus for me. The Bible says in John chapter 3 and verse 16, God so loved the world. God so loved David.
So
that he sent Jesus. So that Jesus will die for David. David will have life everlasting. The last time I came, I told this story. There was a man who was a very experienced bus driver.
saksa bus gari ko chalai na chang
big he used to drive the bus up on a very steep mountain
arwa abri aslam na ka bako ma rama ko sa dong na manaya chang
one day he called his home
arwa sala sa ob nok
china phone and he said to his wife I'm coming home tomorrow
arwa jaka bana amara ta ma khnalo no bana re bhai
ga the wife and everybody in the home was very excited The next day at noon, the man began to rise up the mountain to come to his house. And every time the bus went up on the steep mountains, people in the bus were very frightened. And then it came to a point where the bus was on a real steep cliff. And as the bus was driving up, all of a sudden to everybody's horror, there was a young boy running towards the bus. And he was waving his hand. The bus was coming closer to the boy. Everybody in the bus was frightened. People were holding one another. But the bus was coming closer and closer. And then in 1 minute the bus drove on top of the boy. And people could hear the boy scream and die. Everybody in the bus was angry. The bus driver safely took the bus to safety and he stopped. Everybody was so angry. They began to scold the driver. What a horrible man you are. You killed that young boy. And as they began to scold him, there were tears in the driver's eyes. There was an old man who asked everybody to be quiet. And he said to the driver, why are you crying? And the driver said, that little boy is my only son. If I stopped the bus, it would have gone down. All of you would have died. I allowed my son to die so that you would live. God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son. Yes, sin is painful, but my Savior is powerful. He sent his son. Secondly, if you read from 1 Peter chapter 1, verses 17 to verse 21, the Bible says Jesus became my substitute on the cross. He took my place. I should have died, but he died for me. Peter says, you have not been redeemed with flesh and blood. You have not been redeemed with silver or with gold, but you have been redeemed with the precious blood of Jesus. He took your place. There was a young boy who died suddenly. His parents were wondering if their son was saved.
Monday
they were clearing his things. And when they were clearing his things, they found one of his writings in the book. In that book, the boy had written this particular happening. One day he had a dream. And in that dream, he was in a big room like a library. And in that library there were many cupboards. And all those cupboards were the names of people.
మందిరాన్ని భీముకు సేకమన్నా గణించాం.
There was the name of Ashok Andrews there.
అశోక్ అండ్రూ భీముకు సేయా.
So the little boy opened the cupboard.
అనిగమని బాబుకు సలోకహ.
And he saw that all the sins that Ashok Andrews had done were written in that cupboard.
అరబా వనొందుకో అశోక్ అండ్రూ జేజే పాప్రము బాబుకు సేయా బబ్బే ఏదొమచాం.
There was the name of Pastor Whitfield there.
వరో పాపము వైటర్ఫీల్డ్ భీముకు నొమచాం.
He opened the cupboard.
వాల్కు వహా.
All the sins of Pastor Whitfield were written there.
ఎవరు వైటర్ఫీల్డ్ పాప గమ్మకు బాబుకు సేయా
నొమచాం. He began to look around.
అరబా బిసాని ఇవలవల.
He wanted to see his cupboard.
వావ్ ఉని drawer ko baniras
ka. And then he found his drawer.
Aruba wam kun ka.
And he opened it.
Aruku waha.
And he began to see all the sins he had committed.
Aru ni khagwan blak paprangu ni yaha cha.
There were hundreds and hundreds of sins.
Aru chanir cha paprangu na.
He was pulling out the cupboard.
Aruku salam mati yaha cha.
And it was coming like a kite string.
Aruwa wara lekha dore ni khalde ka tau khatra na yaha cha.
It was coming and coming.
Aru khata ingwa.
And suddenly the boy heard footsteps.
నికోన బిసా జాకురంకు జాకుకు కనా
హౌ యు ఆర్ ఫ్రైటెన్డ్
ఓకేనా
హూ ఇస్ కమింగ్
సారీ వెంగసై
విల్ దే సీ మై సిన్స్
వా అమ్మి పాపరంగు నకనో
హీ బిగన్ టు పుష్ ద కబర్డ్ బ్యాక్
వే వా వా దొలత్ పిల జతంగా
ఆ ఇట్ వాస్ సో ఫార్ అవుట్
అనే బాబన మెంద్ర ఉపేహా
హీ కుడెంట్ పుష్ ఇట్ బ్యాక్
అరకు ప్రతమం
సో హీ లే డౌన్ ఆన్ ద కబర్డ్
వే వా వా టు దాప్స్నా
హీ వాంటెడ్ టు కవర్ దోస్ సిన్
వా పాపరంగు దొనిన జతంగా
అండ్ హీ లుక్ ఫ్రమ్ ద కార్నర్ ఆఫ్ హిస్ ఐ
అరమ కచ్చచ్చినియత
టు సీ హూ వాస్ ఇన్
అమానినా
Jesus began to look at his sins.
Aru Jesu ne pap ro koni na bachega.
And in the bottom of every sin.
Aru a pap ni pap ko sia ni khama.
The boy's name was written.
Bohwa pichani bimo ko sia nongcha.
Jesus took a pen.
Jesu pen ko raha.
And he cut off the boy's name.
Aru ma no pichani bimo ko dena ha.
And he put his own name.
Aru ba uni bimo ko sa sia ha.
The boy said, "But Jesus, you did not rob."
అరువా బిషావన ఓజిషు నా అదే రాశికి రాజచం
జీసస్ యు డిడ్ నాట్ స్పీక్ లైస్
ఓజిషు నా అదే పోల్ జచం
బట్ జీసస్ యు డిడ్ నాట్ రాబ్ ఫ్రమ్ యువర్ పేరెంట్స్
ఓజిషు నా అదే నాని మా బోనికు చావు జచం
జీసస్ యు డిడ్ నాట్ డు లస్ట్ఫుల్ థింగ్స్
ఓజిషు నా అదే నా గిజ కన్నకు కాజచం
జీసస్ యు డిడ్ నాట్ వాచ్ పోర్నోగ్రఫీ
ఓజిషు నా అదే నా గిజ కన్నకు
జీసస్ యు డిడ్ డు డ్రగ్స్
ఓజిషు నా అదే డ్రగ్స్ నాకు చక్కం
జీసస్ యు డిడ్ నాట్ డు ఎనీ ఆఫ్ దీస్ థింగ్స్
ఓజిషు
Him that knew no sin,
Jayan pap ko visa,
he became sin for you.
Wanapna pap kalbo maha.
When he was on the cross,
Jesus was chisolo ma.
The Father placed the sins of the whole world on Jesus.
Pagaba agal sa nila pap ng korabayon ni ko sabo kata.
All the sins you have committed,
lahat na ni kagawan pap ram,
were placed on Jesus.
Jesus ni ko sabo donata kumana.
Tonight,
yawalo.
God says, my son. Took your place.
Isona na ang mga pante ng nipiyap ko raha.
It was 5 o'clock one morning.
Prangni bunga bajio chang sao.
There was a young man who was going to be shot down in the firing squad.
Bisa saksa ko sulay gorong ng pamiyapo wala siya chang.
He had done something terribly wrong.
Harapwa. mari banam jabe yakota paha
and so they were waiting at 5 o'clock in the morning
arwa prangne bunga bajero mangko bona singa cha
because when the chapel bell rang at 5 o'clock in the morning
maina prangne chapel ne khanta ko bunga baje to ko
the firing squad would shoot the man
wa gugappa mandira ra sipai ra ko gugen cham
they blindfolded the man
wa mang mande ko mukron khata paha
and they made him to stand there The firing squad was ready now to shoot him.
Now go boy so na kamara ara daring acham.
The general was looking at his watch.
Araba da bakko boni gori goninga.
It was 4:59.
One breeze of mas kuba jong.
20 seconds to go.
Minute second concrete point kwa.
10 seconds to go.
Second skin bon koinga.
9 seconds.
Second skin.
5.
Second boa.
4. 3. 2.
Bini.
1.
Sa.
It was 5 o'clock.
Arwan bunga baje maha.
But the chapel bell didn't ring.
Ane ba wa chapel ne khonda ko dokja.
So they waited. Still didn't drink. The general said, take the man inside. I want to go and see what's happening at the chapel. When he went to the chapel, the bell ringer was ringing the bell. He was a deaf man. He couldn't hear, but he rang the bell every day. And he was ringing the bell. So the general was even more confused. So he ran up the steps. And he went right up to the bell. And when he went up to the bell, he stood there and didn't know what to do. Because the center gong of the bell, there was a young lady holding on to the center gong of the bell. And as the bell was being rung, all her hands and all being broken and wounded, there was blood oozing out of her body, but she was hanging on there. And the general said, who are you? She said, I love that young man. I will hang here so that he can be saved. Jesus hung on Calvary so that you could be saved. Sin is painful, but my Savior is powerful. God sent his Son. Jesus was my substitute on Calvary. Thirdly, Romans chapter 5 verses 1 and 2. The Bible says, I am secure in Jesus. Because of what Jesus did, I have peace with God. Because of what Jesus did, I have access into the presence of God. Because of what Jesus did, I'm going to be with him in glory forever and ever. Because of what Jesus did, God would look at David and say, David, I will call my son the son of David. Yes, sin is painful, but my Savior is powerful. The pleasures of sin are short-lived. Be sure your sin will find you out. What you sow, you will reap. Sin separates you from God. The shame of sin does not leave you easily. But how beautiful. My Savior is powerful. He sent his Son for me. His Son was the substitute on Calvary. And if I come to him tonight, I will be secure with him forever. I read about a young girl in Germany. She was a pianist, but she was a very poor girl. She wanted to make money quickly, so she made a poster. She said, come to the concert. I'm going to be playing. And right in the bottom, she said, I was the student of this great pianist, Franz Liszt. But she was never the student of Franz Liszt. She thought she could cheat the whole world. But just after she put the poster up, the next day there was another poster on the wall.
살가보나 높은 포스터로 갔다.
When she looked at that poster,
아, 포스터 군요.
She became frightened.
왕케나.
Because that poster said Franz Liszt was coming to town himself.
Franz Liszt 아담한과 타운나리.
And he was going to be playing at the same day at a different time.
아르바바 앞산 살론.
Now the girl got very frightened. She said, I've done something very wrong. I don't know what to do. But then she decided on doing the right thing. She decided to go and confess her sins. So she went to this great pianist. And she said, Sir, I'm sorry. And the man said, Why are you sorry? She said, Sir, this is what I've done. He said, I'm happy you confess your sin. And then he said, Let's do something. He said, You sit on the piano and play now. She sat on the piano and played. He said to her, You play well. But let me correct a few things. After he corrected her, he said, Now you can go and play. You can tell everybody that I taught you. But he didn't stop there. He said, You can also tell them one more thing. Tonight in your concert, the last song, I'm going to play. Every time I hear that story, think of what Jesus did for me. One day I came to him. I said, Lord, I did something wrong. He said, I forgive you. He said, I cleanse you. And he says, the last song I will play. I won't be playing the last song. Jesus will play the last song. Yes, sin is painful. But my Savior is powerful.